The Philippine Stock Exchange bucks a regional downswing Thursday as traders digest twin policy decisions here at home and in the U.S. This report.
Regional equities on the decline Thursday as traders digest the U.S. Federal Reserve's policy decision. The Fed left rates unchanged for the second time this year, but signaled it could hike borrowing rates for the last time this 2023. The Philippine Stock Exchange Index, however, closed on a positive note at 6094 just before the Philippine Central Bank announced rates will remain steady. It also said rate hikes are not off the table yet. Ed Francisco, president of BDO Capital, says the decision did not come as a surprise, but he is hoping rate cuts will come sooner rather than later.
For me, the optimistic scenario is earliest is second half or second quarter of next year is when they will start rate cutting already. Yeah. That's optimistic. I guess the pessimistic scenario is that, you know, with the global economy will still be in the doldrums. The Philippines, for example, will not be able to recover yet and bring down inflation, and it will be postponed till the end of 2024. The nice thing about Governor Eli was at least he knows what's happening in the ground.
In corporate news, business tycoon Fernando Zobel de Ayala has returned to the board of directors of the Bank of the Philippine Islands. BPI says Ayala was elected to replace Romeo Bernardo, who was appointed to the Central Bank's Monetary Board. Ayala was also named a member of BPI's Executive Committee and Personnel and Compensation Committee. He was BPI's Vice 3.8 billion peso five-year term loan for the Philippine Realty and Holdings Corporation. The loan will help finance the company's Casa Unico project, a 40-story upscale residential condominium in Taguig City.